I am the redeemed of the Lord. I have been redeemed with the precious blood of Jesus. God, can I tell you another secret? There's a revelation for you. You're not redeemed from the law, because you were never under the law. Israel was redeemed from the law. You are redeemed from yourself and your way of thinking. God help me. Isn't this good, Josh? You know what? You see, you were never under the law. The church was never under the law. Damn it, hear me. You were never under. Get this! And somebody comes to beat you up about the law. The law was not written for the church. He said, a new covenant I will make with them after those days. He said, if the law could have been perfect, then I wouldn't have another covenant. Amen. I'm giving you, the law was not written for the church. I mean, everybody said, let's say that you understand. Let's go. The law was not written for the church. Everybody say it again.
The law was not written for the church.
One more time.
The law was not written for the church.
If you got that, clap your hands and give God praise. What you gotta do now is you learn how to live in victory, right?
Amen.
So that's what meditation is all about. And I'm gonna give you one more point of meditation before we have plenty of time. Can I might even hoop now that something have all this time. Meditation, walking to him. I'm talking to somebody. I know my gifts. God sent you here to get this. Glory, I'm talking to somebody. God sent you here. Somebody invited you here. Knowing who you are, so you can get what I'm talking about.
Amen.
Now, I speak quite a number of business in here today. I don't know who I'm talking to exactly, but hear this apostle speak. Shut no! Shut no! Shut no! He can't know! God sent you here to get this. This is the answer to your innermost desires. Those things you don't even know how to pray about. God sent you to hear these words. Let it go and live. Let it go and live. Go away to God. Let it go and live. You're trying too hard to get it right. Lord, have me in the morning. Brethren, my heart desire for Israel, Romans chapter 10, is that they might be saved. Before I bear witness that they have a zeal for God, but not according to truth. God, because they go about establishing their own righteousness and denying the righteousness which is of God. God, help me. When you're trying to do it to get righteous, that's your own righteousness. The righteousness of God, friend, is by faith. You get it by believing. Stop trying to cross every T and dot every I. You lose yourself to be free. Walk through the things that God placed before you. It isn't up there by happenstance. The devil didn't put them there. That's God did.
Amen.
Oh, I done lost the whole church here.
Wow, wow, wow.
Don't you know that you are foreknown and predestined? Your life is not a mistake. Nothing just happens.
Amen.
I know that's right.
Whom he did foreknow? You don't believe the word. He also did predestinate. Sometimes when that devil get in my mind over these last 2 weeks based on all these great things God doing around me, try to tell me, oh, it ain't gonna work. But I'm predestined, devil. I begin to meditate. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate.
Yeah.
I'm before ordained under good works with God, before ordained that I should walk in scripture, scripture, scripture. So if I have those scriptures, I don't care how you tell me it's not gonna work. I know it's gonna work because God said it.
Amen.
Because my life is not a mistake. Every person I'm meeting now has been designed before I was born.
Amen.
Anybody with enough faith to believe that, please clap your hands. Let the devil know you believe God this morning. Ain't no matter what he tells you in your mind, you believe God, you've been predestined, ain't no mistake. Before the world was formed, God knew who you were. But he said, before I formed you in your mother's womb, I knew you. And I ordained your life. For I know the thoughts I think towards you. They are thoughts of good and not of evil. Watch it, and to bring your life to an expected end. If it's expected, that means what? It's already done. God says, you have not the spirit of the world, but you've been given the spirit of God so that you can know the things that have been freely given you of God. If you need to know them, they're already freely given and they're already done. I need to talk to somebody to hear the heart of God. I'm not going to finish the message. And I want you to focus. I want you to hear. I want you to focus. I want you to hear. God is moving his people in a whole other realm. And I hate hate to say this, but my wife will be witness. You know, my prayers are at least 2 hours. I spend time in his face about these things. I'm not listening to nothing on the internet. I'm before him about these things.